Hello everyone, myself Dipali Devde. I am going to explain about appendix. Normal structure of the appendix. Let's see what is appendix. Appendix is a vestigial organ which serves no useful purpose in human beings, but instead becomes a site of trouble at times. It is like diverticulum of the cecum, usually lying behind the cecum, and varies in length from 4 to 20 cm, average 7 cm long. Histologically, appendix has four layers in its wall: mucosa, submucosa, muscularis, and serosa. In this picture, appendix is clearly seen. It is tubular organ, blind at one side, and just finger-like projection. As we see, innermost lining of the appendix is mucosa. This lumen is covered by mucosa. This is transverse section of appendix showing mucosa as innermost lining, which has patchy distribution of crypts, and the submucosa has abundant lymphoid tissue in it. Argentine and non-argentine endocrine cells are present in the base of mucosal glands just as in the small intestine. Muscularis is shown in this picture. This has two layers, inner circular and outer longitudinal, as elsewhere in the alimentary tract. Outermost covering of the appendix is serosa. Diseases of appendix are acute appendicitis and its complications, pseudomyxoma peritoi, tumors of appendix, that is carcinoid, cystadenoma, and rarely adenocarcinoma. There are two important diseases involving appendix are appendicitis and appendiceal carcinoids. Let's see appendicitis. Appendicitis or acute appendicitis is acute inflammation of the appendix. Is the most common acute abdominal condition confronting the surgeon. The condition is less more commonly in older children and young adults, and is uncommon at the extremes of age. The disease is seen more frequently in the West and in affluent societies, which may be due to the variation of the diet. A diet with low bulk or cellulose and high protein intake more often causes appendicitis. Ischiopathogenesis. The most common mechanism is obstruction of the lumen from various ischiologic factors. That ischiologic factors may be obstructive or non-obstructive. In obstructive, it may be faculith, calculi, foreign body, tumor, worms, diffuse lymphoid hyperplasia, especially in children. In non-obstructive, it may be hematogenous spread of generalized infection, vascular occlusion, inappropriate diet lacking roughage. Hence, our diet should contain roughage, that is diet fibers. These obstructive factors leads to increased intraluminal pressure. This presses upon the blood vessels of the appendix to produce lack of blood supply, which causes ischemic injury, which in turn favors the bacterial proliferation, and hence acute appendicitis occur. In this picture, we can see the man suffering from severe pain in mid to lower right abdominal region. Acute appendicitis has inflamed appendix as compared to normal. In this pic, we can see appendix with inflammation, increase in size and mass, and it is also reddish because of rich in blood supply. In this picture, we can see the diagrammatic representation of the inflamed appendix. In this, abdominal pain is due to visceral nerve fibers and gut flora, which is already present in our appendix, also multiplies and causes stimulation of immune system. Morphology. Morphologic features of the acute appendicitis depend upon the stages it suffers from. In early stages, organ is swollen and serosa shows hyperemia. In well-developed acute inflammation called acute suppurative appendicitis, the serosa is coated with fibrinopurulent exudate and engorged vessels on the surface. In further advanced cases called acute gangrenous appendicitis, there is necrosis and ulceration of mucosa, which extend through the wall so that the appendix becomes soft and pliable and the surface is coated with greenish black gangrenous necrosis. In this pic, we can see gangrenous appendicitis clearly, that blackish necrosis area we can see. This is microscopic view of the appendix showing four layers histologic we have discussed earlier. That uppermost lining is mucosa, below that there is submucosa showing congested vessels, and below to that there is muscularis. Now most important diagnostic histological criterion is the neutrophilic infiltration of the muscularis. In early stage, other changes beside acute inflammatory changes are congestion and edema of the appendiceal wall. In latter stages, the mucosa is sloughed off, the wall becomes necrotic, the blood vessels may get thrombosed and then may be neutrophilic abscesses in the wall. In either case, an impact foreign body, fecalith or concretion may be seen in lumen. Now moving towards clinical course, patient presents with features of acute abdomen as under. First, colicky pain, initially around umbilicus but later localized to right iliac fossa. Second, nausea and vomiting. Third, pyrexia of mild grade. Fourth, abdominal tenderness, increased pulse rate. Neutrophilic leukocytosis with toxic granules in neutrophils is most significant laboratory finding. An attack of acute appendicitis predisposes the appendix to repeated attacks called as recurrent acute appendicitis, and thus surgery has to be carried out. If appendicectomy is done at a later stage following acute attack, pathological changes of healing by fibrosis of the wall and chronic inflammation are observed. Complications. If the condition is not adequately managed, the following complications may occur. Peritonitis, that is a perforated appendix as occurs in gangrenous appendicitis, may cause localized or generalized peritonitis. Second, appendix abscess. This is due to rupture of an appendix giving rise to localized abscess in the right iliac fossa. This abscess may spread to other sides such as between the liver and diaphragm, into the pelvis between the urinary bladder and rectum, and in the females may involve uterus and fallopian tubes. Third, adhesions. Late complications of the acute appendicitis are fibrous adhesions to the greater omentum, small intestine and other abdominal structures. Fourth, portal polyphlebitis. Spread of infection into mesenteric veins may produce septic phlebitis and even liver abscess. Fifth and last, mucosa. Distension of distal appendix by mucus following recovery from an attack of acute appendicitis is referred to as mucosa. It occurs generally due to proximal obstruction but sometimes may be due to benign or malignant neoplasm in the appendix. An infected mucosa may result in formation of empyema of the appendix. Thank you.
Hey guys, thanks for being with me till end.